Genetically Modified Organisms. Hello, our curious viewers who are science lovers of our page. Today, we're going to talk about GMOs, genetically modified organisms, and GMO, genetically modified organisms, foods that we've all heard about over and over in your life, and we think you'd really want to know what happened. But first of all, we need to know what GMO foods are, right? Let's take a look at some GMO foods. But before we get to the subject, a little reminder, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like the video in order not to withhold your support for us and science lovers. Now, what is genetically modified organisms food actually? Genetically modified foods. Genetically modified foods, or bioengineered foods, also known as genetically modified foods, are foods produced from organisms whose DNA has been modified using genetic engineering methods. This is how GMOs are defined in many sources. Let's examine a little more. So when did these foods appear and when did they enter our daily life? To summarize the history and development of GMO foods, we can say the following: as a result of the rapid developments in molecular biotechnology and gene technology, the first food product of gene technology was produced in 1960. The process that started with gene transfer in bacteria in 1973 has gradually accelerated since the 1980s. With the start of commercial production of transgene plants in 1990 and the introduction of the genetically modified tomato named FlavorSaver, which was obtained by recombinant DNA technology, in 1996, the production of these products started to spread rapidly all over the world. GMOs have started to be used not only in agricultural production but also in many areas such as the pharmaceutical industry and environmental products. Now let's find out what genetically modified organisms foods are together. GMO foods: soybean, corn, cotton, milk, sugar, aspartame, canola oil, pumpkin are among the most known GMO foods. How are genetically modified organisms foods produced? All phenotypic and genotypic features of organisms are found in DNA and RNA, and these features can be changed. The production of GMO foods is made by using the whole part. We can produce GMO-containing food in two ways. 1. Transfer of a gene from another organism instead of a gene belonging to any feature found in DNA. 2. Gaining a new feature to the organism by differentiating the gene in DNA with biotechnological applications. Why do we produce genetically modified organisms foods? The biggest reason for this is that the crop in the field is wanted to be made more resistant to the pesticides it is exposed to. As of now, the United States, India, Argentina, Brazil, and Canada. Most of the corn and soy are grown in the US, about 85%, is GMO. Potential benefits of GMO: it increases the nutritional value of the products. The products become resistant to insects and diseases. It increases the production amount of the product. It reduces the use of pesticides. In addition to these benefits, it also contains some risks. Potential risks of GMO: scientific research has revealed that GMOs carry potential risks as well as all these advantageous aspects. While GMO-containing products or products containing GMOs may cause changes in food quality, they may develop antibiotic resistance and potential toxicity, or may cause disruption of natural diversity and the possible formation of new viruses and toxins due to gene escape to non-target organisms. Despite all these risks, GMO foods are spreading rapidly and everywhere in our lives. We will see the benefits and harms of this product much better in the coming years. We hope maybe one day someone does better. That's all for today. Hope you all like it. For more, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like the video. Let's meet in the comments. Goodbye.